So in this video, I share with you three ways that I ground myself. And I don't just share them with you, but I actually take you with me and I show you the exact things that I do that I've learned how to ground myself into the present moment. Now, first off, the thing I want to do is share with you what grounding really is. Well, grounding is when we anchor ourselves into the present moment. It's when we really connect to the present energy of who we are. Now, with that being said, I'll say that in society, especially now more than ever, we have technology. And with technology, while there are many, many benefits of it, there are sometimes side effects of it that cause us to be more, I guess you could say, conceptual. It almost brings us, because we're staring at a screen, it brings us more to a place to where we're more stimulated with our thoughts, we're more identified with what we're thinking about, and then it turns out to where our thoughts are more thinking us rather than us thinking the thoughts. So it's almost like that switch gets flipped. But what grounding allows us to do is switch it back to where we are present into the moment, and then we are able to then more readily become and use that present energy rather than us being used by our mind as much. Now, I kind of had to learn this out of necessity, I guess you could say, because when, if you know a little bit about my story, I used to have ADHD and I took Adderall, which is the prescription drug they give for it. And from taking that for years, I decided I wanted to find something else. So I learned meditation and that completely changed my life. It changed my energy, and within like 2 weeks, completely got rid of Adderall. And I learned these three things I'm gonna share with you kind of out of necessity. And they're three things that have had a huge impact on my life. So what I'm gonna do now is show you the first one of what I do. And it's one of the ones that I enjoy doing the most. And let's go do it now. So this technique is the most powerful technique that I found for being able to ground myself. Now, it's simply coming outside and deciding to walk barefoot on the ground. And I've been doing this for years now, and I find that when I do it, I sleep much better at night, my stress levels tend to go down, and I tend to just simply feel more balanced. Now, with that being said, there's also coming out some levels of research that are showing that this is actually something that's good for the body. One of those is showing the effects that it has on the negative ions of our body. Like, our body is naturally at a negative ionized state. What happens is as we go through our daily life activities, and now, I mean, since especially because we walk around in shoes with rubber in between us and the ground, the idea is that we are more than ever immersed into the idea of technology, which means that those have EMF waves, and it's affecting our energy to where now we have an abundance of positive ions that we accumulate throughout the day. Now, one of the simplest ways of balancing out our energy is coming outside where there's an abundance of negative ions. In the planet and in grass, there's an abundance of negative ions, and therefore when we come here, we're more likely to balance our state out naturally. If you can't sleep at night and you have problems sleeping, try grounding yourself before you go to bed. It's something I do every single night. I come out here just for a couple minutes and decide that I'm going to walk barefoot on the grass, and I find that I sleep much better at night simply because of that. But more so than ever, they're starting to really understand that there's benefits to the idea of grounding. It's going from some, you know, spiritual, like woo-woo idea to something that's becoming more and more understood. And I think in the future, they'll just kind of, it'll come to be more accepted as something that's very beneficial to the body. Just like, you know, eating healthy has now been shown that it has an effect on our immune system and, you know, how we are and our energy levels. So eventually I think it'll be something that's proven, but until then, the only way you're really gonna know is if you decide to go out and try it for yourself. So get outside, see if it works for you. Now, the second part is about knowing how we can ground ourselves with juicing and vegetables. And Aaron, really, it's Aaron, something that I've been doing for a while now. What?
Yo, what's up?
What's going on? What's up, bro?
I mean, your video is going good so far.
Thank
so
you.
Far, pretty good. I'm just a little bit confused because we're talking about the idea of grounding ourselves, like walking on grass. And you're over here trying to get people to eat more fruits and veggies. I'm just saying, I have this feeling that you're just trying to get people to eat healthier.
Right.
Because It's a little bit hazy on how this correlates to the topic that we're talking about
today. Well,
I'm
going to explain that.
Relate it a little bit more.
Right.
That'd be a little bit better.
Okay, well, I was just getting ready to do that. I'll explain how it relates. Now, I know this seems like something that's a little bit off topic from the idea of, like, grounding ourselves while we're in grass. But this idea comes from understanding, first off, that the foods that we eat can be grounded in the idea of nature itself. Now, the reason I think this is so important is because there's more and more research coming out that's explaining the benefits of eating nutrient-rich foods and that effect that it has on our mind and our body. So not only will our immunity system be a lot stronger, we'll get sick less often, not only will our brain work better because we'll have more clarity because we're actually giving it the nutrients it needs versus giving it a whole bunch of artificial supplements. But the idea is that that allows us to, one, remain in more of an alkaline state. Now, I've talked about this in a couple of my videos, but the main benefits of being in an alkaline state is because when we're in that state, it's more likely that our body is in balance because acidic foods and the idea of viruses can only spread in an acidic environment. And just like that, our body is in the same way, dependent upon whether we are acidic or alkaline. When we are alkaline, we are less likely to get sick. And one easy way for us to be alkaline is for us to eat more nutrient-rich foods, whether that be fruits, smoothies, and juicing, and that has an effect on us then staying at that negative ionization that I talked about in the first part of this video. If our body stays there, we're more likely to be grounded because the idea is that we're actually more healthy to begin with, and therefore we have more clarity. So while it may not be the most obvious reason, while fruits and veggies can allow us to have more grounded type energy, it helps us to be more present in the moment because we're not as stimulated by artificial sweeteners, by sugar, versus actually being present because we're giving ourselves the nutrients that we actually need. Is that good enough?
To be honest with you, now that you said it like that,
you get it a little bit more now.
It's a little bit more clear to me.
Yeah.
Just saying, not accusing you of trying to
get you
healthier.
I'm just saying.
But that's what it looked like.
Okay.
All right. You did good. You did good.
Okay.
Gold star for you.
All right. So for the third one, I figured I'd bring you right back here. Now, what I do for this one is actually something that's very simple, but this is probably one of the most powerful things you could do for becoming more present to the moment. Now, I'll say that with this, I know anytime that I'm more conceptual in my head, just by the tone of my voice. Like, there'll be certain indicators that kind of show us whether we're present to the moment or whether we're more in our heads. And the tone of my voice always gives it away for me. Like, right now, you might be able to tell that my voice is very full, it's very grounded, and when it's not, you can even like look at some of my earlier YouTube videos, my voice is a lot more high-pitched. I'm more inside of my head than I am actually being present to the moment. Now, this grounding exercise is something that really gets me back to the present moment, and it's actually very simple. You can do it when you're at work, you can do it when you start to feel any scattered. You know, this also counteracts the idea of technology, of always being stimulated by the environment. So rather than our head using us, we then allow ourselves to be present so that we can then objectively use our mind rather than our mind using us. So this is what we do. If you could just get very relaxed right now, and all you have to do is, you can be standing, you can be sitting, whatever you're doing, but what you can do is bring the awareness within. Now, one of the easiest ways to do this is to first off just feel inside of your hands. So put your hands out like this or like this, and all you have to do is bring the awareness into your hands. So you could do your left hand and your right hand. And what you can then do is take a deep breath in with me right now. And what we're going to do is just put the awareness into the sensation of the breath coming into us and then the sensation into our hands. So we're just going to focus on feeling rather than thinking. So right now, take a deep breath in with me. And let it out and bring the awareness into your hands. And into, now you can bring your awareness into your left foot, your right foot, and then take another deep breath in with me right now. Once again, let it out and feel into your hands, feel into your left foot, your right foot. You don't have to feel into all of them all at once, although you can, and that is a good indication that you're becoming more into that body awareness than into the conceptualized thinking. But what you'll find is the more that you do that, the more that you breathe into your body, the more present you're actually able to feel, and then you're less consumed by your thinking. So hopefully right now you feel that. You feel more present to the moment with me right now. You feel that body awareness. And now what you can do is go throughout your day and know that you are grounded into the present moment. What you can even do is take this a step further. And now that you feel into your body, learn to observe your thoughts. So now that you feel present into your body, observe the next thought that comes into your mind. Become very aware and very alert of the next thought that comes into your mind. Let's do that right now. A lot of times a very funny thing will happen, because when we become alert and we become very present, we'll find that the thoughts start to space a little bit. It becomes less thinking because we're observing our thoughts rather than thinking and being identified with the thoughts that we're thinking. So this simple process of observing our thoughts, of becoming present to the moment and bringing the awareness into our body, is one of the most powerful things that we can do for becoming grounded into the present moment right now. You can do this at any time throughout your day, and I promise you that the more that you do it, the more present you will feel, and the more that you'll actually feel like you are immersed to who you are meant to be. So with that being said, remember the three things that you can easily do are ground yourself into the environment by going outside, maybe walking barefoot on grass, drink some green juice or any type of juice that is from the environment. So, you know, you could juice, you could make a smoothie, whatever that might be for you. But know that that's an easy way to revitalize your cells and to have yourself become more physically grounded. And then the third one is the most powerful. Learn to bring the body awareness inside, and as you begin to do that, you will begin to feel more anchored into the present moment. So I hope these three things help you at some level today. Understand that the power is within you to become more present to the moment, not necessarily you needing some external pharmaceutical drug like I did for the longest time in my life. And there's a lot of power in knowing that the power comes from within. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Feel free to like this video if you liked it, share it if you found it of value, and I'll see you guys on the next vid. Stay grounded and much love. Peace.